I don't have this one next to
me. Good
boy. I came home from work one day to find my father sitting on the front porch. He masked the look of fear and worry in his eyes that took the form of a broken accordion. You see, my father started working to help his family at age 10. He left school in the third grade to chase the dream of a simple life and food on the table. I've never seen a smile on his face like the days when he had to drive away at 4 a.m., coming home in the evenings, tired, sweaty, and happy. He used to go out on his days off to play music just for fun, charging money per song for his friend's sake. My father comes from a time and place where work is a man's job. He grew up with sweat on his brow to the steady beat of his accordion, where he released his overflow of joy. With this accordion, he flirted with my mother. I imagine she was pulled in by the happiness he could resonate through it. With this accordion, he played with me when I was young enough to only recognize it as Papi's favorite toy. A crash left us moving back and forth, unsteady job to unsteady job. I pretended to believe when my mom said, "We just can't decide where to live yet, mija." A crash disabled our moves. While we all worried about my father's well-being, he worried about our only form of income of transportation. Where a heap of truck lay, he saw his days out of work, jobs turned down, smaller paychecks, his purpose shattered before his very eyes. A crash of heavy metal from my father's hands left him broken, struggling to work like a dusty CD player, pushing to finish the song. My father just wants to get by, and I may not understand how this system works because I don't see how the contents of his wallet or the status of those bills in the mailbox decide his ranking as a father. I don't see how he owes the government money for unemployment. Now my father stands in bars nearly every night, drowning in silent prayers that someone drowning in too many beers can lend an unappreciative ear to one song, $10 a piece, for his pride's sake. I listen when he practices because for once, he's just playing for himself, and if you listen closely, you can almost hear him smile. But now it's broken, and I sift through yellow pages trying to find someone that can fix it. My father is broken, and I sift through wanted ads trying to find something that can fix it, because Papi, I'll pay anything to hear you smile again.